The introduction is an important part to give everyone else a chance to see what you're thinking. You'll lay out your case for the introduction. What did you see in the research you did? What kinds of journal articles gave you the ideas you did? A lot of students think that, well, you know, this work has already been done by somebody else. I shouldn't be, you know, tipping my hand and showing that I went and cheated by going to the library. The introduction gives you a chance to assemble the work of other people and explain the reasoning. Lay out your case. How come you think this will happen? If it's experimental research, give enough background that someone can see why your hypothesis is expected. Sometimes an experiment is what I call spray and pray. You know, you find a cool chemical, you want to dump it on something and see what happens. That's not really how science works. You have a logical reason to think that this substance A will affect substance B in this way for these reasons. So your introduction should have references. It should definitely start maybe from a broad perspective, maybe say chromatography does this, and then start talking about more details about the type of chromatography you're doing and zero in on exactly what you're trying to study. So the introduction needs references. It should be full of background information. You can assume your reader knows a little bit about what you're doing, but give them a chance to maybe check up on you, you know. You've read the paper, let them read the paper too. Give them a chance to figure it out. So the introduction sets the stage. It's like opening arguments for a court case.